Hello, and welcome back to Demons of Problematic. Here we start with some nasty ambush, right off the bat. Nothing too terrible, but you can get stuck and be raided by these three guys. One thing I like about this map already is that you start exactly the place you left from. The door where you came from closes and two new others open. I find it quite nice and it makes sense. Here is the Super Shogun if you missed it in the previous level, but we can't get to it yet. Let's start some secrets. This thing, I have no idea what it is. Don't ask. Like in the first level with the Monkubai texture thing. Good thing I have some secrets that aren't just ammo and stuff. It's a nice change, but maybe a little annoying to find stuff that aren't useful at all. This map, contrary to the first one, is much more linear, but still pretty good. We already plenty stock on ammo right there. And yeah, we already got the Berserk as well. It's a good thing to get the Berserk, you have the option to use it. Because yeah, Berserk is funny, but since, yeah, like I said, we stocked on ammo, there's no point to use Berserk since you can use pretty much anything else. And since this map doesn't use keys instead of keys, you have to do switch hands. It's not too bad. The only bad thing is about secret switches and these kind of things. There will be one much later, but later on in this level that's kinda bullshit. It's impossible to find if you don't know it's there. Or, like usual, triumphing every wall in every room. Fighting in Descent and you have plenty of health and armor, especially if you find secrets. Like, you start this level with a sulfur power-up you get from visiting the last one. Soon we will get a penny rental spawning far, and this guy is a dick. He's very far, so you can't hit him properly with any weapon except the chain gun. And yeah, it's going to be a pain in the ass if you don't notice him and let him spawn 10 lost souls everywhere. I'm going to have a few troubles right there, a few seconds. One bad thing about using the weapon change back I'm using is when you tap the chain gun to snipe enemies, instead of doing two shots it does one, so you have to click twice as much to do the same amount of damage you usually do. That's because of the way the decorate code is made for the weapon in order to use the new sprites animations. And here we got the plasma gun. And as you can see, bottom right, we're almost fully stuck on ammo for this. So we'll soon start stop using weak weapons and just spend those. Feels good to have some power once in a while, not facing wars of barons and stuff like that. You have to feel like you have some power. We don't have any BFG now. Here's a secret switch behind this pillar. Open this secret right there, and that switch opens up to the next area. And you have to press it in order to progress. And of course, it comes with its ambushes. This part can be a little dangerous if you stay down there and being shot by the revenants. But now it's time to murder revenants with a plasma gun. I bet none of you like revenants. They are garish guys. It's a bombing shot and stuff. Hopefully they make some sound so you know when they are on. It's kinda hard to avoid the throwing projectile in these corridors if you can't back fast. Too turbo. Here we'll backtrack to through the same area again, but there's some new enemies spawned and we won't backtrack much, so it's good. Yeah, like in the first part, we have a secret that leads us further into the level to the last part. Except this time you can't skip most of the level, some part of the level, because there's some invisible walls blocking us from going down there. I'll be showing this son of this guy as dead. Yeah, here's the final area of this level. Like I said, we'll be going there later. It's a good thing to see, like, next area we'll be going before going to them. It's like, hey, I'm seeing this and I'll be go there. It's nice to see that. And here, now there's some invisible stairs and these guys look kinda suspicious. Sorry. We need to press this switch to advance the level. And there's this super shotgun right there. When you take it... Oh, corpse was flying. Yeah, these guys activate and will ruin your day. These guys have more health and do much more damage than normal lost souls. And if you stay down there, you'll probably die. So there's two different things you can do. Maybe three or four. You can stay down there and bend the spikes so they don't hit you. You can rush up there and pick them one by one. You can die, of course, and there's another solution I will be showing pretty soon. I'm very worried of one of them being still alive and getting me in the back at some point. So yeah, in this secret, right there, will open soon because yeah. There's so much in this level, but they're all placed in a way that's not that dangerous. I don't have much stuff to revive and you have some cover. So yeah, it's a secret in a secret. This one is not too hard to find because you kinda see it. But yeah, not that obvious. So yeah, here's this inventory sphere. That's not a really good place to use it. Like right there, there's not that much enemies. You can pick them off by staying back. So you may want to use that inventory sphere for the solo suit, but you don't have the super shotgun. But you don't really need the super shotgun that much since you have so much ammo for the last one. The whole thing, everything. Don't clear us pretty quickly, so we can't clear up everything in this area. Taking the red key there triggers this, but you don't actually need the red key to open anything, I believe. Keys are just there for jokes, I think. And if you go there and rush down there and get the key and make enemy spawn, you can get stuck there because sometimes up this elevator which is the only way out. But you could be camped by Iron Knight and stuff, and if you didn't clear the up, I mean, the enemies up there, you can have Revenants and Monkey Bay shooting you from the side. And that can be very bad for you. If you clear everything carefully, it won't be an issue. And I love keeping my ammo balanced for some reason. So here is that bullshit secret. Pressing this wall there opens a secret back there. There's no way to know it exists. You may think there's a secret right there, but finding the switch is almost outright impossible. It's not another Arshrite, pretty harmless, since you're pretty much stuck in everything. This secret is kinda obvious, I mean, when you look at the wall positions, makes sense of the secret there. And that was the place we were before. So nice to see the thing from both ways. We won't be able to get up there to get this ammo again, so we better take everything before going down. So this part is a little interesting. We have some enemies down there. But if you want to dispatch out with a rocket launcher. A lot of gives and corpses. But as you can see, we have some Chaos Demons coming and the enemy count is increasing. Which is a very bad thing. Oh, here's some extra armor. So in these two towers right there, there's Chaos Demons spawning of it at regular intervals. We also have some enemy barons or skin enemies that are impossible to kill. But we'll be dealing with them pretty soon. So you can't do anything about these towers right now. You have to press these two switches near the portal far there. And we got one. And you see, we're trafficking these guys. It's the only way to kill them. Like, we're trying to shoot them right there. So they reflect shots and are invulnerable to the rest. So you should hurry to get to the next teleport, which is not kinda obvious, this one. When you press the 2, the portal opens, this guy dies, and we have to wait for some animation, I guess. Which is kinda funny. Oh, and now Chaos Demon stops spawning, hopefully. And this guy can take you by surprise, so you're like, hey, corpse is coming out to the border, and then, oh, hey, so. A good thing about having a lot of Chaos Demons stocked right there is that you can do some pretty nice fighting. Like, almost all of these are trying to attack the Cyber Gym, which is pretty nice. And flying Chaos Demons are on our pen in the ass, so with the infight, it's a very good thing. Makes your life easier. Like this guy, when you with them, especially in Zed Dooms, I get pushed so far away, gets really a pain in the ass to kill them. After infighting, this guy is very easy to dispatch because he was almost dead. The portal is open now, but I have still one secret to show off. Which is a pretty good one. To find it, you have to go up there, in this teleporter right there, after I get some armor back, of course. Here we go. And you have to keep going this way and open a door that's there. Found it on my first try. Spawn these guys. How cute. But they bite. So guessed it. It's pretty satisfying to destroy lots of these mini cyber demons right there. It's a pretty funny secret. So without further ado, let's jump into the last level. And we are now in Sidonia, the final encounter of this mod. We got plenty of ammo, much more than we'll ever need. Like, I'm almost stuck of everything entering this level. And this is the first part. First part is some fighting some guys outside right there, killing a cyber demon and opening the central fortress, you could say. It can be a little tricky because you don't have very much cover. This thing on the right around recover because the shots will still get you. And you don't want to fall off the map as well. Sabaldemon is kinda harmless because he's stuck in this place. Some invisible line prevents him to cross. So all he does is shoot the, you from this place. Not too hard to avoid. But they're pretty bland, just shoot them until they die, like usual. Also having a big destroyer can be a little annoying, like in TNT there's so much guys. Having different bosses can be a good thing. Okay, phase 2. Phase 2 opens a fortress and something happens. This fireball fell out of the area and spawn some imps, infinitely. So if you wait there for a long time, there will be a lot of imps. And that can be a little problem, so you have to make haste. Haste. So go to the next part, you have to press these 4 switches near each door. Nothing out since there's not a lot of imps spawned yet. After pressing the 4th one, it's phase 3, I guess, where no Cacodemons spawn. Imps start spawning now, so it's not too bad. Continue, you have to go up the towers and press these 4 switches again. The elevators go up very shortly after getting down, so you have to have a pretty nice time. And you really have to move faster to not get overwhelmed as shit with the Cacodemons. There's already plenty of them right there. And the last phase right there spawns a group of Outrise from the teleport. Which can be a big problem if they resurrect some Monkeybi and Barons and stuff. Hopefully most of the corpses right there are imps. So it's not that much of a threat. The only threat is the fact that you don't have that much cover, you have to back out very far to get out of the side. This encounter is pretty good, but it's a little too short and too easy, so I was kinda underwhelmed by this. You can start this level by himself since you get every weapon to start. And you don't really need that much, it's really easy. As long as you don't fuck up going up the elevator to the towers, you should be fine and don't even have to retry dodging stuff. Trigger part being the Ashrise, of course. And after King's Ashrise, the portal opens. It's green. So let me find the last guy who is in somewhere and get out of here. To the epilogue. So we're back where we started. Sulfur is gone. Damn. Everyone is dead. Everything is destroyed. So sad. You have to find a way out of there. There's a secret door behind this blue-green wall right there, but it's impossible to open and doesn't count towards the amount of secrets at the ending starts. And I have no idea who this guy or this thing is, I just don't know. It's a pretty fun secret, look at this. And yep, that's true. Never seen any of this, that's pretty rare sight. So this is the end of Demons of Primatic. I hope you enjoy it, and I will see you for Demons of Primatic 2 and some more TNT.